Because this year I turned 70, believe it or not. And the Susan Sawatz and the show McTimmy's come on. As a revolutionary woman, Lolita de Roma tell me, Nena, por favor, tapate sus niños. Lolita, ¿qué tú quieres que yo haga? Bueno, me dice, ay, mija, yo estoy en una reunión con Don Pedro, y Don Pedro me dijo, y Lolita, para. Su generación era otra generación. La mía es otra generación. She looked at me. Ironically enough, this afternoon, Lolita Lebron's sister called me from Puerto Rico. Because she wanted to know, was I okay? Tell me that is not part and parcel of being loved by our ancestors. Mm-hmm. And people ask me, you know, how did you become a TV producer? I'm going to tell you the real story. Banda León got Gerardo Figueroa and Jerry Rivers a scholarship to Columbia University. Okay? Yes, that's the truth. All right? And then Jerry calls me. Because I never knew him in the world, Jerry. He's always been Jerry. He said, Dean, I need somebody to talk about. You know, I'm doing Like It Is with Gil Noble. I said, well, maybe Pedro Pietri. I go, Pedro, and I said, yo, bro, call Gerardo. I want you on the show. They're going to take you tomorrow. He goes, yo, Ducho, you crazy. I said, shut up, I'm going to pay attention. And then Pedro went. He finished his day. ABC comes into my house. I live on 10th Street. He's in 176 East 10th, my first apartment. And he comes upstairs. He rings the bell. He said, yo, bro, what happened? I said, what? Bill Watson wants a co-host for Like It Is with Geraldo Rivera. I said, uh-huh. He said, you gotta do it. I said, I don't know you with Jerry on camera.
Jerry.
So Bill Watson comes to my apartment and he said, oh, chuleta, profunda gule, uno cara no maduro. And then he tells me, oh shit, I'm nervous. I said, don't be nervous, brother. Did I get the job? And I got it. But then Jerry, who's now dancing with the stars, the motherfucking kid in the room. Oh, you see him dancing? I did your commercial when you were with. And when you did the moves and I tried to show you how to do a melody, I'm like 47, you're so careful with your body. The universe conspires. You know, the universe conspires. And my conspiracy is every single one of you that have played a major part of my life. You know, I could not have survived the 20 years of my revolutionary sabbatical without the memories that I have with each and every one of you. Because it has been an incredible life that I had before, during, and now after. Sometimes it's difficult, you know? But you know what? I'm in freedom. And my comrade, Oscar, is still inside. You see, in prison, people messed up and people don't have a way to express themselves, a way to feel free, a way to feel part of the universe, you know? So I decided to create a holistic healing program while I was inside. And then I decided to teach low impact aerobics. And that Zumba bullshit, I started Zumba in federal prison, baby. Friday we did salsa and R&B. And you can call it fluffy. I did. And you know what? The women loved it. And guess what? I was in a co-ed prison for 7 years. So I was able to jam. Hello. Yes. That doesn't exist anymore. It doesn't. Shut up. That was crazy. But the truth of the matter is that humanity exists in every occasion in life that we have. live in this crazy world and we forget that our people that are behind locked doors and they don't have an avenue outside, but you know what? They have a spirit. And their spirit was creating a holistic healing program. I told them salsa, but then I created, I brought all the biggest, baddest, and the biggest of all of California to do healing work. Even though you say la gente del mundo, and they thought they were healing, but you know what? They also taught me, I taught my sisters, and after coming out of prison, I made a choice of life. I lived in several places of Puerto Rico, but in 1974, I was doing a TV series, and the young man was here earlier, he had to leave. Michael Lynch was this young black kid who was brilliant. I used to call him black people. He is Michael Jackson, goddamn, from the South Bronx. He was 19 years old, and I hired him to be part of Infinity Factory. And then he was gay. And he's not here because he had a rehearsal tonight. He had to leave early. But he always says, D took me out of the closet. There are no closets to be had. There's a closet of the mind that people create. And Michael now today is an incredible artist. He doesn't need me to take him out of the closet because he is for real. And when I arrived in Puerto Rico, my experience in shooting at that period in 1974 in Loiza, I said, wow, I want to live here. If I come out of prison, I wasn't even thinking of going to prison. But it was the closest thing to our community that we used to have. Remember what El Barrio was? Do you remember when we could go on the weekends and sing Duba? Do you remember when 110th Street, the Congueros came and we played conga on the corner and on the 104th Street in Madison, that El Boricua had a jam session? That doesn't exist anymore. Why?
Because
we've been gentrified. But you know what? We can't be gentrified in our hearts, mind, spirit, and soul. This building is the essence of a liberation process for artists. I have decided that where I live in Loiza, when I was there in 74, they were developing this community. I said, coño, qué chulo. I like these houses. And guess what? I live there. And the beach that's two blocks from my house, and some of you have been there and know where that is, right, Gladys, right? Maria, what? Yes, you do, my baby. Yes, you do, Pat. Shaky, Jay. Those of you have had the courage to come to Loiza because people get scared. I tell everybody, motherfucker, don't be scared. What? I come from East Harlem. I grew up in there against the poor people. Get put there, you know? I live in Loiza, and you know what? I'm calm, but there's a need to do what I want to do, and that's why I'm here to ask you to help me. Casa Luisa is not like Dylcia's avenue of creating bullshit. No, no. I want to create a healing home for men and women, a healing place where people can come and learn. See those little gourds? Making each piece is not easy. I don't have an assistant. I would love to have a digital frame. I don't want technology. Absolutely, but I ain't got the money to buy it. But to take only huera, a Puerto Rican gourd, you take it from the tree, you have to let it either ripen and use it ripen, and then you have to take a Dremel costs $89. George bought me my second one. Yes, you did.
Second.
Yes, you did. George Carver did. You have to take it, I have to put a mask on, I have to open up, and then I have to scrape it, and then I have to put it in water, and then I have to put it in bleach, and then I have to clean it again.
So don't think if you pay $35 for that little piece that you're giving me a lot of money. You ain't giving me shit. You know, Mickey Melendez is not here, but he always said, D, price them at your hourly rate. And the truth of the matter, it is not easy taking an iguana and shaping it and painting it. And then Mickey's wife bought me the engraver. Oh my God. I love clay. I'm an incredible ceramic artist. If you come to my house, you'll see I cannot afford to make clay. I can't. I decided when I left prison, I left $3,500 of paints so that my fellow prisoners could paint, could use all my ceramic paint. I left $1,000 of tools so that they could have classes of ceramics. What I learned in healing, I do body work. There's Walter Bosch, our master acupuncturist. He comes to put in, I'm talking now, doesn't want to come back. I don't know. But you know what? I learned, and Bob Delero taught me the same thing. Bob was a master activist, lawyer. He did everything, but then he became this healer. And I have become a healer. I have wonderful hands. I want to turn my home. But you know what? When you get everybody's vibes inside your home, I don't like all that negative energy in my house. Am I correct? Do you like all that? No. I need to do a second floor that looks like a gallery, but then I can do body work. And then people that have been to my house, I have a balcon, I have an outside yard that I'm fixing a little by little, but we can do talleres. I took all the visuals of those cards. I have a collection of boxes. Because here in New York, every company puts out these incredible propagandas of visuals. Our people need to create their mirrors of spirituality. Our people need to reinforce themselves inside their hearts and soul and mind of who we really are. If we don't do that, brothers and sisters, compañeros and compañeros, we are this close to losing our nation. Rest assured. Today's a historical day. Yeah, so I just saw Obama. Oh my goodness. He wants to give Cuba democracy. Me cago en Dios, puñeta. Cuba has had a socialist approach to life that democracy needs to learn what it's all about, more and more. You know? In 2007, thanks to Mickey Melendez and the Cuban government, I spent 11 days in glory. The beauty, you know what it was? Walking down car streets, and I said, come on, look at those old floors, but guess what? It was like being in a Puerto Rican gallery in the 50s, or the Puerto Rican apartments. We came from the island of the 30s, or my grandparents came in the 20s. They said, "Coño, it's cold here." And everybody painted their walls a little hot pink, green, yellow, pero baby, in enamel, so it could shine. And all the cars in Cuba shine, and they shine about reality. I went to the AIDS Center. Bullshit, the United States. Those people are surviving and they're living well. And they're incredible human beings. I mean, Obama better release Oscar Lopez.